Hi, Chuck Huber here for the State of YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit a Probit regression model that includes a continuous and a categorical predictor as well as their interaction. I'm also going to show you how to test hypotheses about the predictors, how to estimate marginal predictions for the model, as well as create some graphs. So I'm going to be using the NLSW88 dataset, and you can download this by typing webuse NLSW88. And here I've described the three variables we'll be using for this model. Union is an indicator variable for union membership, and it's going to be our binary dependent variable. Age is a continuous predictor, age measured in years. And then industry is our categorical predictor. It's the industry that the employees work in. Notice that there is a value label attached to industry. It's INDLBL, so I've typed label list INDLBL so we can see the various categories of industry. So one represents ag, forestry, fisheries, two represents mining, and so forth. So let's begin by going to statistics, and I'm going to go to binary outcomes and select Probit regression. And then in the dialog box here, I'm going to select for the dependent variable, I'm going to select union. And then for my independent variables, I'm going to use this three-dot box to set up my model. So I'm going to click that little box with the three dots on it. And for the type of variable, I'm going to leave factor variable selected. And then for the specification, I'm going to leave main effect selected. So I'm going to start by selecting the variable age. Age is a continuous variable. And so I'm going to check this little box underneath C dot that tells Stata that age is a continuous variable. And I'm not going to use time series operators or base or anything like that right now. So I'm just going to click add to var list. And that will add age to the list of independent variables here. So I'm going to click submit. And if I look at the command here, the dialog box issued the command probit, followed by our binary dependent variable union, followed by our continuous predictor variable age. So let's also add industry to our model. So let's go back to the dialog box and click the little three-dot box here. And again, I'm going to select a main effect, and for the variable, I'm going to select industry. Industry is a categorical variable, so I'm not going to check the box under C dot this time. And again, I'm going to ignore time series and base. So I'm going to add industry to the var list as well, and then click OK. So this has been added to the independent variables list, so I'm going to click submit. And now let's take a look at the command. The command is, again, probit. And it's added industry to our list of covariates. And notice that the dialog box put an I dot in front of industry. The I dot tells Stata explicitly that industry is a categorical variable, and it creates indicator variables for each category of industry for us, so we don't have to. Okay. So let's go back now and go back to the dialog box, and let's add an interaction. So for the specification, I'm going to select interaction two-way. And now I'm going to select my two variables, age, and I'm going to check the box underneath C dot because age is a continuous variable. And I'm going to select industry, and I'm not going to check the box underneath C dot because industry is a categorical variable. So now I'm going to click add to var list and then click OK. And it's added that to the list of independent variables. And we'll talk about what that means after I click submit. So now that I've clicked submit, let's take a look at the command here. So the command is again probit, union, age, and so forth. And notice that we've added to the list of independent variables c.age and then this little sharper hashtag operator here followed by industry. That's the interaction term for age and industry. So what is all this stuff here? So the c dot tells Stata explicitly that age is a continuous variable. The little hashtag operator here tells Stata that we want to see the interaction of age treated as continuous and industry treated as categorical. Notice there's no operator at the beginning of industry. There's no I dot or C dot. By default, Stata is going to assume that if we don't specify anything, industry is a categorical variable. We could have put the I dot in front of it just like we did over here. So we could have I dot industry and that would be perfectly fine. Same thing with age, where there's a C dot here, we could have put a C dot over here and that would have been fine as well. So that includes the main effect of age, the main effect of industry, and the interaction of age and industry. Now let's go back over to the dialog box, and I want to show you a shortcut way to do this. So I'm going to delete everything from independent variables, click on the three-dot box, and at the bottom, I'm again going to delete everything from var list. So now under specification, I'm going to select two-way full factorial. And for the first variable, I'm going to select age again, and I'm going to check the box underneath C dot because age is continuous. Again, I'm going to select industry as my other covariate, and I'm not going to check the C dot because industry is categorical. Now I'm going to click add to var list. And when I click OK, I'm going to go ahead and click OK again because I'm finished with the dialog box. If I scroll back up, my command now says probit, followed by union, which is my binary dependent variable. And then I just see this thing after. It says c.age, hashtag, hashtag, industry. So the double hashtag operator tells Stata that I'd like to see, all in one thing here, it tells Stata I want to see the main effect of age treated as continuous, the main effect of industry treated as categorical, as well as the interaction of age and industry. And if I wanted to, just to be explicit, I'm going to click on the command here in the history window to send it to the command window. Just to show you that I can do this, I'm going to put the I dot in front of industry. Okay, and then press enter. And now if I look at the command, that's what my predictor variables look like. So again, I have the main effect of age, the main effect of industry, C dot, I dot, as well as the double hashtag. We're going to ignore some of these notes here at the top. And then just go down through the results here. I see some statistics at the top, the number of observations, the likelihood ratio chi-square, the p-value for the likelihood ratio chi-square, a pseudo r-squared. And then I see the main effect of age, the main effect of industry, and then at the very bottom of the output, I see the interaction of industry and age. So if I look down the list of p-values, all of these p-values for the interaction terms look fairly large. But if I wanted to, I could test that all of those coefficients are simultaneously equal to zero by going to the command window and typing test parm. And then I'm going to type c.age and then a single hashtag here and then i.industry. And what this is going to do is test that those interaction terms are all simultaneously equal to zero. Okay. So I get an omnibus chi-square test here, the test statistic, as well as a p-value testing for that interaction. Now, unless you are good at thinking on a probit scale, it can be challenging to interpret these coefficients. So an easy way to interpret those is to estimate marginal predicted probabilities. So I'm going to go to statistics and scroll almost all the way down to the bottom where it says post-estimation. So I'm going to click post-estimation. And this opens the post-estimation selector. And this allows me to do things like goodness of fit analysis, predictions, tests, and contrasts. But I want to estimate some marginal effects. So I'm going to check this box here to expand the marginal effects, estimated means, and interactions menu. And I'm just going to do some basic stuff. So I'm going to select basic and low dimensional analysis, and then click launch. And this opens the margins dialog box. So in the main tab, I'm going to start with my categorical predictor variable, and then for the categorical predictor, I'm going to select industry, and then for the analysis type, I'm just going to do marginal means of outcome for levels of covariate. I could do elasticities or contrasts or other things, but I'm just going to keep this simple for now. So I'm going to select that and click submit, and what that's going to do is issue the command margins industry. And the output then shows me the marginal predicted probability of union membership for different industries, different categories of industry. So for construction, the predicted probability of union membership is about 0.18 if I were to round it. For manufacturing, it's about 0.26 rounded. And this is adjusted for age, because remember, I also have age and the interaction of age in my model. So these probabilities are adjusted for age. Now, if I wanted to, I could come back to the dialog box here and actually estimate the predictions incorporating age as well. So I'm going to select interaction analysis with another covariate, and this covariate is continuous. Remember, age is the other covariate in my model. So I'm going to select age, and then I need to specify values to compute estimates at. So I'm going to type 20, 10, and 80. And what this is going to do is estimate the marginal predicted probabilities at age 20 through age 80 in increments of 10 years. So I'm finished with this. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. So if we scroll back up and look at the output here, let's look at the command first. The command is margins industry, so for each category of industry, at ages 20 through 80 in increments of 10 years. So the at, it shows us a legend here in the output. At 1 is refers to age equals 20, at 2 refers to age equals 30, and so forth. So then in the output, I see the marginal predicted probability for, say, a 20-year-old in the wholesale retail industry is about 0.05, if I were to round it. For a 20-year-old in the finance real estate industry, it's about 0.52, if I were to round it. So I get a lot of output here at the bottom. And so a handy way to visualize all of those predicted probabilities is to create a profile plot. So I'm going to go back to the post estimation selector here and select profile plots after marginal analysis, and then click launch. And this opens the margins plot dialog box. So in the main tab for the variables that define the x-axis, I'm going to select at age, okay, and then click submit, and let's see what that does. So that creates a profile plot, or a collection of profile plots really, for age, where age is the horizontal axis, the vertical axis is the predicted probability of union membership, and then I get a separate line for each of these industries. So there are a lot of different categories of industry, and so this can be tricky to read, and so we might want to customize this or do other things to make it a little easier to read. One thing that we might want to do is create this graph, create a separate small graph or a panel of graphs, one for each industry. So if I go to create subgraphs for groups defined by variables and select industry, when I click submit, now what I get is a panel of graphs. So I see a separate profile plot for each industry separately. Another thing that I could do is if I go back to the dialog box, I'm going to remove industry there. And in the box below that, I'm going to select industry to create graphs for groups defined by variables. So I've just gone to the box below that. And now when I click submit, it's doing it so quickly. It goes by so fast, you can hardly see it. But what it does is it creates an entirely separate graph for each category of industry. So I still see age on the horizontal axis. The vertical axis is the predicted probability of union membership, and then I get a separate graph for each category of industry. So for instance here, in the entertainment industry, looks like the probability is pretty low up to age 40 and then pretty high after age 40. There's a jump in here, although this may be an artifact of the data set because those are pretty extreme. But anyway, it will create a separate graph for each category, okay? So let me show you one last trick here. By the way, you can go through and customize the titles and the colors and the legends and all of those things if you want to. So I'm going to close the dialog boxes here, and I want to show you a little trick. I'm going to come over here to the history window and right-click any of these commands and select select all. And then I'm going to right-click again and select send selected to do file editor. And that's going to send all those commands that were generated by the dialog boxes to a do file. And I can save this file and then rerun the entire analysis anytime I want just by running this do file. It also allows me to view the options for each of these commands. So this is a handy learning tool as well to view the commands and learn about the option names and things like that. So that's how we can fit a Probit regression model that includes the interaction of a continuous and a categorical predictor, test some hypotheses, estimate some marginal predictions, as well as create some graphs. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.